Good morning, everyone. I hope that you are all safe at your home and you are doing well. And also, I hope your studies are also going well. So, till now we have finished three chapters, that is sentence, phrase and clause. I would repeat once again, if there is any problem regarding the previous three chapters, please do let me know. On that basis, I'll make, that means those classes, I can make like such kind of videos on for clearing out your problems. And the notes which you got, okay, you have understood or not? Actually, now, right now, what the time is, we all know what now is going on. And if by those notes something is not enough for you, then I'll try my best to provide you some more things. Okay, so if you have any problem regarding any of the part anywhere, then please let me know about it. Okay, so today we are going to start our next chapter, chapter 4, that is we are going to talk about nouns. This is not a new concept for you. You already know this from very small classes. You have got this nouns. So it is not actually a new thing for you, so we'll revise it today. So first of all, what are nouns? Nouns are naming words. We all know that. Now, name of anything can be noun. Yes, name of a place, name of a person, name of anything can be noun. Now, these nouns are divided into how many types? They are divided into 5 types. Okay. Yes. Now, okay. One more thing. The name of any quality. Okay. First of all, noun. Noun is the name of any person, place, thing, or any quality. These all are nouns. Then coming to the types of nouns. First we have proper noun, common noun, material noun, abstract noun and collective noun. Yes? Did I repeat anything? No. Okay. First of all, we have proper noun. Name of anything specific is proper noun. Let's read out from your book also. A proper noun is the name of a particular person, place or thing. Anything specific. Okay, only that thing. If we are talking about a boy named Ram, then we are only talking about the boy Ram. The name Ram. Okay, that is the particular thing. We are talking about only that boy whose name is Ram. Okay, like that. And always remember, this proper noun always starts with capital letter. Never forget this or never make mistake in this. Proper noun means capital letter. Next, number 2, common noun, which takes both boy and girl as common. For example, teacher. Yes, we refer to our teachers as ma'am or miss or sir, like that. But teacher is teacher, okay, be it, because a boy, a male person will also be called a teacher, a female will also be called a teacher. Next will be, okay, let's take children, okay, or then doctor, player, and what else, we can say? Yeah, country, city, river, okay, names of various rivers, Yamuna, Godavari, Kaveri, all these names of these rivers can be taken as one common noun, river. Then, third one, what I said, material noun, yes. Those nouns that that are made for from any substance or any material. Suppose, for example, steel. okay, then bronze, okay, then what else, wood, okay, these are all material, these are all material now, silver, aluminium. Let me read out the definition for you. A noun that stands for the matter or a substance of which things are made. Okay, let's take a chair. A chair is made of wood also, plastic also. So we will not take chair, but we will take wood or plastic. That is our material, or that is our substance. Okay, like that. Then abstract noun. Yes, abstract nouns are the ones which cannot be seen but can be felt. We cannot see the abstract noun, we cannot touch the abstract noun, we can just feel it. Anger. Can you see anger? You can see an angry person, but can you see anger? No, that's a feeling. Okay, you are feeling angry, you can feel it, you cannot see it. Next, if a person is good, if you think, I like this person, why do you like this person? Because that person is good. But have you seen the goodness? No, you have felt the goodness within the person. Okay, then if a person is talking rude to you, always his behavior is rude. Okay, that person's behavior is rude. Will you say that can you say that you have seen rudeness? No, you have felt within yourself that the person is rude. You have not seen rudeness. Okay, these are some of the qualities. Okay, these are actually the qualities of some persons, or these are actually qualities which we feel. Okay, and okay, then a cup of tea is made and accidentally you touch, your skin gets touched with the hot cup of tea. Can you see hotness? No, we can feel it. Once your skin will touch the hot cup, you will be like this, right? Why? Because you felt hot. You felt hot, you did not see. So these are the abstract nouns. And then lastly, we have collective noun. Now collective nouns, collective itself, the word collective means collection. Okay, a class of students, there are lots of students, so we will refer to them as a class of students. This class all, obviously they will be have students, so they are class. Then soldiers, army. Okay, then what else? Yes, teachers. While all the teachers are present, okay, while you see so many teachers together, you don't say them as teachers. We say, that means while the collection, okay, actually taking them into collection, that is called staff. Then what else? Yeah, you play cricket, you play many games, so you make team and you play. This is one side, this is another side. Okay, so that here also there are players and this side also there are players, right? So both the players, in this side also there are players, this side also there are players, they are playing against each other. We cannot say them as players, we'll say that they are teams, that they are opposing against, or they are playing against each other. Clear? These are the five primary types. Okay, when we say, remember this thing, when we say or when we ask what are the types of nouns, we know that there are the five types, that is proper, common, collective, abstract and material. These are the five types of noun. And apart from the main types, these are the main things, okay, these are the main types of nouns. Apart from the main types, there are two more types, that is countable and uncountable. Obviously I don't have to explain that, we already know what is this, which can be counted is countable, which cannot be counted is uncountable. Now I hope this part is clear to you. And wait, there are some more things to be discussed here. Okay, you will mark this paragraph for yourself. That means this, wait, let me show you. This, what is called noun, what are the kinds of nouns. And now let's see if there is something to mark from countable and uncountable nouns or not. Firstly, the definition is given, examples are given. Okay. Some words can be used, yes, you mark this line. Some words can be used both as countable and as uncountable nouns. For example, some houses are made of stone. Stone is an uncountable noun. Okay. Yes, stone, you might think that one stone is there, two stone is there, maybe we can count, but stones are not countable. Okay, the child threw a stone at me, you cannot. Now, okay, the way it is used, see here, some words can be used both as countable and uncountable. In some sense, we can consider stone to be countable, in some sense, we cannot consider. For example, some houses are made of stones. Some houses are made of stone. Sorry, I'm saying stones. Some houses are made of stone. Now, how many stones are used in making that house? You cannot count that. Next, the child threw a stone at me. In this case, stone is called a countable. Next, the articles a or an can be used with countable nouns in the singular form. A bat, a ball and umbrella, these are all countable. For example, a painting, an egg, etc. Uncountable nouns can only be used in singular form with indefinite articles. A or an cannot be used with them. Again, mark this. If you read these points, now there are 4 points. If you read this, it is clear to you. Uncountable nouns can only be used in singular form and with indefinite articles. Okay? A or an cannot be used with them. We cannot say a brass or an honesty. Honesty, brass, they are uncountable and they we will not use any a or an with them. Okay? Countable nouns are preceded by words or phrases like a few, many, several, two or three. A few coins, a few cows, many countries, two bananas, etc. Like this. Yes, and one more, what is given? Uncountable nouns are preceded by some, much, a little or less. Hope you have understood up to this. If you just see very nicely, the examples are also given here. This 4 points you will just mark. Sorry, 5 points are there you will mark. At last, this dot is not given, but it is also a type. You just read up to this and then in our next class, I'll give you when you have to read the remaining part. Okay, now you just read up to kinds of nouns, countable and uncountable nouns. Okay. Okay, we'll finish up to this today and in our next class I'll instruct you what you have to read. Till then, stay safe and stay at your home. And yes, regarding any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you.